G'day everyone, if you are looking at incorporating drone technology into your business, then this video is for you. My name is Aaron Rajamoney from UA Visuals, and we are a drone and technology service provider based in Australia, and we live and breathe this industry. I'm so excited to be able to talk to you about how drones can greatly benefit your business. We have partnered with DJI Enterprise, and we have an exciting three-part series where we'll cover what you need to consider when starting a drone department, developing your drone fleet, and maximizing your data with the latest software on the market. We've been flying drones commercially now for close to 8 years, and we've seen the evolution unfold in front of us, from screwing on propellers to today, a powerful, foldable solution that takes less than 60 seconds to get in the air. Following this evolution of drones also comes the evolution of businesses, and we're noticing plenty of small to large scale companies onboarding drones as an integral part of their business. As mentioned, we are based in Australia, but the advice on equipment, applications, software, and principles can be adopted for almost any region across the world. Just ensure you consider your local laws and regulation when it comes to using drones for commercial purposes. More information on that in the description below. But right now, let's jump into it. Step one, what are your drone needs? Before commencing your licensing and research process, it's a good idea to decide on what kind of capabilities you need and what drone will require to get the job done. Do you need thermal capabilities to see temperature variations? Do you need RTK for accurate mapping, surveying and modeling? Or do you need high resolution zoom capabilities for inspection work at a safe distance? Remember, you don't need to be a Top Gun pilot with hundreds of hours of flying experience. Today's drones will do the hard work for you. For instance, let's take solar farm inspections. This process is now as simple as setting a flight path and hitting a button to send the drone on an automated path while capturing thermographic images along the way. Taking it up a notch in weight, the M30 or the M300 series are larger aircrafts and have more capabilities overall, particularly with their weather resistance, dual battery solution, and versatility of additional payloads such as LiDAR, a higher megapixel camera. However, these come at a higher cost. Additionally, the type of drone you use may affect the type of license your pilots or business may require. So for example, if you're using a large drone like the M300 for LiDAR work, you might need to get a license in a different weight class, which is the case for here in Australia. However, with the most recent addition of the Mavic 3 Enterprise series that offers features such as RTK positioning, a mechanical shutter, and thermal capabilities, this offers the perfect entry point into the enterprise market. Step two, licenses and permissions. Do you need a commercial drone license? If you are a company looking to expand your capabilities into the drone services, the answer is definitely yes. Sure, there are caveats like indoor exclusive drone work or farm use on private land. However, if your work is outside of the exemptions, then gaining the necessary qualification is a must for all your pilots and businesses from both an experience and insurance point of view. The process will vary depending on the region, and so we have a link in the description for resources on this in your area. Before getting a license, another important question to ask is who is your chief pilot or who will be in charge of the drone division? Who will be the person that all operations flow through for checks and approvals? It's important to know this before moving forward as they will be the ones who will need to research and be up to date with the laws and evolving capabilities of the drone industry. This process can be a little bit daunting to begin with, so you may want to consider bringing in a consultant to assist in setting up the foundations. Step three, deciding on a drone management system. A DMS or drone management system is imperative to overseeing your drone program to help remain compliant. It's essential for safe operations as well as fleet management. These systems will help plan operations, confirm flight paths, as well as gather essential information regarding airspace, such as NOTAMs and no-fly zones. Some DMSs can also include procedures for conducting risk assessments, tracking flight hours, maintaining the drones, and emergency alerts. It's important to have a clear and comprehensive DMS in place to ensure the safety of your equipment, employees, and the public. There are many options currently available out there, such as DJI's Flight Hub 2, Fly Freely, AVCRM, Drone Logbook, and Air Data, just to name a few. Most are subscription-based, with the costs depending on the number of pilots you might have in your fleet. All of these applications offer trials to see if the system will work for you. DJI Enterprise is also offering a free public beta on DJI's Flight Hub 2, which also includes live view capabilities of your drone operations. Link is in the description for more information. Setting up a drone division within your business requires careful research, planning, and investment into people and hardware. Hopefully this video has given you the first steps to take, with the end goal being to save time, money, and bringing these types of operations in-house. In the next video, we talk drones, specifically the Mavic 3 Enterprise series and how their capabilities can help launch your new drone department. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.